Hello friends, today we will discuss a very important application by Google, which is Google Lens. It is one of the most useful applications developed by Google. Basically, it works on the image recognition technology. It has various features such as translation of text. We know that this facility is already provided by Google, but the most interesting thing is there. It can translate the text from any hard copy. For example, if you want to translate our any particular language book in other language, then it can easily translate, and it can also copy that text to our mobile or computer, and we can make some changes in this. For example, if I want to convert my English book to Hindi language or Marathi or whatever our choice language or any particular language that is available in Google Translate languages provided by Google, it can easily translate. We can easily copy this text anywhere. We can save it on any computer and we can make any changes in this. Basically, it can also identify the objects what we see. If we see any particular laptop, then it can identify that, and it can search any images, thousands of images based on that particular pattern. So let us learn how can we use Google Lens app. For this, first we will start from installation process. For this, I just go to Google Store and I search Google Lens. Then I found this. It is a very small app of just 1.1 MB and we can easily download it. As I have already downloaded, I click on open. Now we see that there are 6 options available. First is for translate the language, second is for text, third is for search the items, fourth is for shopping, fifth is for location, and sixth is for dining. We will demonstrate all these options one by one. First of all, the first option is that point to text, that capture to translate. If you want to translate any particular text from or particular any book, we can just click on this point. And I have one book, I will show you. I have this particular book, Ordinary and Partial Differential Equation. And suppose I want to translate some text. Suppose I want to translate this about the book. We can see that एजुकेशनल पब्लिशिंग किताब के बारे में, यह पुस्तक विभिन्न भारतीय विश्वविद्यालयों और विभिन्न प्रतियोगी परीक्षाओं के स्नातकों और सर वट एवर वी हैव रिटन इंग्लिश, इट इज़ ट्रांसलेटेड इन टू हिंदी. इफ़ यू वॉन्ट टू चेंज द लैंग्वेज एंड सपोज आई वॉन्ट टू ट्रांसलेट इन टू अरेबिक, देन वी कैन अप्लाई. इफ आई वॉन्ट टू चेंज द लैंग्वेज, आई वॉन्ट टू चेंज, वी कैन सेलेक्ट एनी लैंग्वेज. Suppose I select French, then it will be translated into French. So this is very interesting option. We can just select the text and click the picture and it will be automatically translated into that particular language. Now I again change it to Hindi. Now if you want to copy this particular text, then we have to just click on copy all. It is copied to clipboard and we can paste it anywhere. Suppose I want to send as a message, then I paste whatever information we have copied, it is available in, and we can just copy it and save, and we can make any changes in this. So this is very interesting application, and we can use, and we during our teaching learning process we have always a problem. If you want to copy some text from book, then we have to type it. Now we can copy it from anywhere. Now we back from it. Second option is point a text that this is similar as we have discussed in first option. It is same as that. Suppose I want I have changed this book. Suppose I want to copy this text, an introduction to data structures. Then I have to just click on this. It is selected. We can also listen it. Suppose I click on listen, then
an introduction CHAPT to data structures. Introduction 01.
So we can also listen it. Now we can select it and copy text. It is copied to clipboard, and we can copy at our any place. So this is very interesting option. We can just click on the text and copy it on our choice, and we can use it later. Next is third option is tab shutter button to search. If you want to search any particular object, suppose I have my laptop, this is HP laptop, and I want to search this, then I have to just click on this. It will show me all the results related to this particular laptop. It will show all the similar kind of images, and we can select any one of them. Suppose I click on that particular item and click OK, then it will select all the images related to this. It will show all the related results. Next option is, if you want to show particular item, suppose I want to buy my laptop, then I have to just click on this. It shows Hewlett Packard company. And we can just go out any website and we can search from anywhere and we can purchase it easily. Now if I want to buy this book, it will show all the results. Suppose I want to search this book, data structure through C, it can search. Now if I want to search this particular book, ordinary and partial differential equations, it is easily searchable. So now we move to next option. We have already seen shopping, and we can also check places. If I want to click any particular background, then it will search all the similar places like this. Next option is dining. If we point out at particular dish, it will show the nearby restaurant to us, and we can order them easily. One most important thing is that that is used by botanical persons. If we want to know the name of any particular plant, then we have to just click on that and we can find the name. I will show you. Suppose I want to know the name of this particular plant, then I have to just click on this. It will show all the details, botanical name. It will show every detail regarding that particular plant, and we can use it in our teaching process. If I want to know this, what is the name of this particular plant, then I have to click on this, and it will show you all the results. I am not a person from bio, so I don't have much knowledge about this, but it is it can be very useful. If I want to search particular, suppose I want to search that particular ball, then it will show all the items related to this. So friends, this is a very important applications, and we can use it in searching of our text. This is most useful in copying the text from hard copies. And if I want to know the name of some particular plants or particular objects, or we are at some place we don't know about that, then we can easily search that. So we can use this app, and as I already discussed, it is a very important app, and each one should install this app. So thank you very much.